What's up, guys? Welcome to the Dutch Boy Poker Show, coming to you live from Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm your host, World Series of Poker Bracelet winner, three times over, Dutch Boyd. And below me is the friendly co-host, Michelle Cosper.
Hello.
XMWA in the Twitch chat. How are you doing, XMWA?
I'm doing fabulous.
So it is episode 47.
Oh my gosh, already.
47.
And it's we're not even close to the 200 yet, Dutch.
We're about 25% of the way there.
We might have to stream every single day until the WSOP. How do you feel about that?
Probably not going to happen. Probably not going to happen.
Okay, we'll see.
But it's Wednesday, May 11th. We don't do a lot of Wednesday streams. But I kind of had an itch to play some poker. The World Series of Poker is right around the corner. We're looking at 3 weeks. And I can't wait. I'm counting down the days. And, yeah, look at this Z-Man. That's redonkulous, Z-Man. We're making the fold. Redonkulous. And Rock and Spin making the call with 9-6 offsuit. Getting there. Head exploding. Like, this is just, this is just awesome. Rock and Spin putting in what was that 50 something big blinds pre-flop with 9-6 offsuit. Z-Man putting in even more than that, double when you consider the effective stacks to his left, with ace king offsuit. Let me tell you something, when you push all in for 100 big blinds and get called, ace king is not going to be good. Except when you're up against Rock and Spin, who called with 9 high. I mean, like, where do these guys come from? Where do they even find the 90 bucks that you need to play this tournament? I don't know. But that was pretty dreadful.
Playing blackjack, Dutch.
Yeah. Drunk blackjack, I guess. Lucky Charms 30 coming in with this min limp. Open limping on the button. I'm going to go ahead and make the call here, getting 5-1 against these two donks. And Rock and Spin, if you happen to be watching, I apologize for the...
You mean to call people donks? That's kind of mean, Dutch.
It was kind of mean, wasn't it? It felt kind of mean right when I said it. I was like, that was kind of mean.
I didn't think you needed to take a nap.
that was kind of mean. But shoot.
Dutch is, yes. He's getting the aggression out for the WSOP.
Gonna make the fold here.
Which one are you playing anyways, the 30?
I'm playing the 30. I'm also playing the 20.
Oh, okay. I'm looking for the 30 right now. 30.
A couple friends of the stream here. John Blaze is chilling out with us here in the 2K guaranteed. But the tournament that I'm going to be focusing on tonight is this 3K guaranteed. If we get busted out of this or we get deep in the 2K, I'll switch back over. I'll also switch back over as interesting hands present themselves. So Paul Daywald in the big blind. I wonder if he's streaming tonight. Probably is. Our buddy Paul.
Yeah, and if you guys want to watch them both, I think we have a little command there in the Twitch stream. I think it's multi-table. If you exclamation multi. I think it's
same
multi.
Amount.
I don't know if it's multi-table or multi. Probably should make it shorter.
And getting the call. Look at this. So we flopped the trip nines.
Are you playing the bounty one? Which one are you playing here?
3K guaranteed. The $30 3K guaranteed.
Well, what's the 20 one?
That's the 2K guaranteed.
Oh, it's a 2K? Okay, I see a bounty. Oh, I see it. No, it's a 10. The 10?
Hold on.
I can't read. Oh, it's a 10. But it's 20 because it's an add-on.
It's a $10 buy-in, 2K guaranteed.
All right. Gotcha. My lucky eyes are watching.
Hold on for
now.
A second. We got Paul Daywald checking to us here.
Oh, gosh.
And that's a pretty lame river. I'm trying to think of what he could call here with. I guess we might get called with ace highs. It's not a good river for us, though, because when he makes the call on the flop and the turn, I'm kind of putting him on a jack. Now he goes in for a check raise. Fucking brutal, man. Just brutal. Just ridiculous. Did we just get two outed here? Did that just really happen? so tired of getting outplayed by Paul. I really am. We're sitting here getting about 2-1 on making the call, but he's just screaming to us, oh, I have a jack. By the way, I have a jack. If he had a jack, would he give us a free card on the turn? Probably. You know, he'd probably just let us keep on betting into him, and then he finally hits the jack, and he's like, oh, maybe I can get him to bluff. Now maybe I can get him to call with a 9. He might have pushed us off the better hand there. Whatever. Whatever. Let's go ahead and look. We'll see if our buddy Paul is broadcasting. Just vomit, man. Well, it looks like he is, so probably get a chance to see what's going on. Maybe not, though. He has the 2K up instead of the 3K, so I don't know. That might be one of those hands that we just will never know. We'll never know if we just messed up there on the end. We're thinking that maybe we get some hero calls there. But Queen 10 doesn't hero call. Queen 10 check raise bluffs or folds. King 10, King Queen probably does the same thing. Thinking maybe they can push us off of. So does smaller pocket pairs like sixes or threes. I could see firing out a check raise as a bluff. So if we're not going to call the check raise, it might be better not going for the thin value bet on the river with what appears to be a strong hand, nines full. But when we get called, we're usually getting called with like an ace high. I mean, that's what we're betting for, right? That's the plan, anyway. Okay, I'm going to lower this volume just a little bit.
Oh, I think we're really loud.
You know, you guys can lower the volume, too, Minty Paws. You can lower your own volume. I kind of feel like it's better to have our volume up, because then the commercials come along and just blow everybody away.
I just work here.
Yeah. Shorty Lambert asking, hey, at Dutch Boy, does the online participation in WSOP.com increase during the series? Absolutely, Shorty. It's quite a bit bigger. The fields are quite a bit larger during the WSOP. We've got Vice Chick in the stream. Great to see you. Papist, John Blaze, Shorty Lambert, WFKS, Poker Mindset Coach. He says, glad you finally got the card. I sent it the first day I was there. So
yes, I have it.
We finally got
it's in the car still. Shoot, I have to bring it up.
We got a postcard awesome. From Thailand, which was pretty cool.
I'm going to start collecting postcards and then post them up behind the wall.
That'd be pretty cool.
I have a lot from all sorts of people. If you guys want to send me one, just let me know, and I'll give you my post off box. I'll send you one, too, if you want. Just message me.
You should do a postcard exchange for sure, Michelle.
Yeah, I'm not going to talk so loud. I'll talk far away.
So I'm watching it right now, and it doesn't look like Paul Daywald is showing what he had. It's too bad.
That is too bad. I wish my Twitch would work, though. I've been having issues. My screen is freezing again. I wonder if I have to update my...
Oh, he's showing computer. He did have the jack.
He did.
So he two-outed us.
Good job.
And we made a sick laydown.
Nice.
He had the jack 10.
What
a sick laydown.
Dutch's confidence
now.
How
sick is that laydown? I feel great. I feel so much better knowing that it was the right laydown here.
Be awesome.
This is him talking about the jack 10.
He's going to call it ace-eye.
Oh, he thinks we're going to call.
had here. I'm going to have to tune into it.
So you guys are multi-watching
each
other. So
he was wondering the same thing.
He's really thinking about it.
It's too funny. Hey, you know, you guys are going to be working together. You guys got to think. Yeah. You guys got to know what you guys are thinking, right? You guys are playing the WSOP tag team event together.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to be
really
exciting.
We're on the tag team event together. We're a team.
Dutch using that whole tie bank.
Oh, that's funny. LOL. He was wondering what you had. LOL. He did have a J.
He did.
Good fold.
He had
a Jack 10. Nice.
I feel great about the fold now.
That is funny. I like that. That's pretty funny.
I mean, it sucks getting two outered.
I know. You made a sick fold.
So. We were going to get all three streets of value from Paul Daywald with the Jack 10. We had him on the ropes down to 4%, and then he got the 4%er, and it sucked. So confidence level raising a little bit. Poker's just as much about saving the money when you're wrong. When you're on the wrong side of those confrontations. It sucks though. You can't win tournaments just by making good folds. It's just. It's not how it works. So luck charms, making another open limp. We got Stephen Rushing resubbing 9 months in a row. We also have Pappas resubbing 13 months in a row, and Decker with 14 months. Guys, thank you very much for resubbing and keeping the stream going. You guys are the best. Thank you so much, Stephen Rushing. Thank you so much, Decker. Thanks so much, Pappas.
Pappas says Dutch seems a little salty.
I do. I feel a little bit salty, Pappas. And it looks like Paul Daywald just got moved from our table. So no more cool multi-twitches with us at the same table yet. Hopefully we'll be making it deep together. GG Donk TV showing up in the stream. Good to see you, man. He says, what's up, Dutch? Good luck. Thank you. And Charlie in SC says, how you, Dutch? How you doing, bro? I'm doing pretty good. Doing pretty good. Just counting down the days, man. I made myself a little construction paper chain. We got 3 weeks until the World Series of Poker starts, and I can't wait. I can't wait. Grinding and ground, chilling out with us. He says he had it. He had Jack 10. And Ferrari Doctors, Jay Carver is on scoop fire. What did Jay Carver do, Ferrari? The scoop, you guys. The scoop. It's a special time of the year for online poker right now. I'm kind of jealous. I'm kind of jealous of the winners. Definitely not jealous of the losers. It can get pretty expensive. 4 of 6, though. That's not so bad. He said Ferrari is saying that Jay Carver's up like 16,000 and has a day two tomorrow. Nice job, Jay Carver. Nice job. The Twitch run good is real. So that pot would have gotten pretty expensive pre-flop, but we would have gotten there. Let's not be results-oriented. I feel good about the fold. Wow, look at Rock and Spin with a 7-2. How does he have a 7-2 here? I mean, he got so much in pre-flop.
Yeah, how does he have that?
Wow.
Huh.
So he raised to 360 with 7-2 suited. Oh my gosh. Raised to 360 with 7-2 suited on the button. I don't hate it. You know, that's fine. You want to raise, that's fine. If you're going to play it, you might as well be raising. You got the big blind re-raising to 920. Now maybe it's time to slow down, but not Rock and Spin. Not Rock and Spin, who re-raises and then calls a 5-bet from 808 grind. he gets 3,200 in the middle there. And then happens to catch lightning in a bottle. I mean, I'm 4-bet and then called a 5-bet with 7-2 suited. Amazing. I love these guys. So here he is with Jack-9 suited, doubling up Z-Man. I'll tell you, I would much prefer this guy to be on my right. It's a lot easier when you've got the complete donk aggro players on the other side of you. Wow, that makes me really regret the way that I played a hand earlier on when I flopped a set against this guy, Rock and Spin. And check raised him on the flop rather than just checking and checking and checking and just letting him just keep on firing and firing and firing. What did he do with his Jack-9 suited just now? I mean, I was so interested in the last hand that he misplayed. I didn't see how he misplayed this one. So he raised to 350, and then you got Z-Man firing out 7,295 pre-flop, just overshoving. Huge overshove. Pre-flop in the 3K pre-rebuy period with Ace King. Just amazing.
Hey, Klein.
Somehow getting called.
Has an awesome story for you.
Klein, let's hear it. He says, Dutch, I have a good story to tell you. I put your patch on the rim of my golf hat. Shot the best round of my life. Nice job, Klein. My partner said, what the fuck is that on your hat? I said, Dutch Boyd sent it to me. He said, no freaking way. Dutch from the WSOP? That guy is a gong show.
He is.
That guy is a gong
show. I wish he had a gong. Oh, that'd be so nice. Every time I, yeah.
Thank you.
Every time I've heard enough of you.
Oh, my gosh.
That'd be awesome. Okay, sorry. And then, but you know what? It is a good icebreaker, isn't it?
Yeah.
3 weeks WSOP starts, Dutch.
Pappa's asking how many events we're playing this year.
Was just supposed to put that up.
I think something like I think something like 30 events on the schedule. I haven't put it up.
Yeah, he's Mr. Procrastinator over there.
Yeah.
But he did finish a book.
Yes, it did. I read Ernest Cline's Armada.
And how did it go? How was that book?
It was wonderful.
Yeah, no, seriously, because you were telling me about it. I guess you don't want to give spoilers. The same guy that wrote Ready Player One.
Ready Player One was the better book, in my opinion.
Okay, and it was all right. Supposedly, you don't have to give anything away.
Steven Spielberg is directing Ready Player One.
It's going to be an interesting book. You know what? We saw The Jungle Book, and that was pretty impressive. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to see what people can do. With their artistic abilities. I'm sorry, I guess I'm reading my email at the same time.
I'm going to have to take a look at my WSOP schedule. See exactly how many events I'm planning on playing here.
Oh my gosh, Iceman Kiwi's sub ran out. What the heck is up with that? Iceman Kiwi! Aw, it's okay. I like your little stinky cheese, though.
It's good to see you, Kiwi. So it looks like 51 different buy-ins are on the schedule. But a lot of those are like, you know, all the different Colossus buy-ins, all the different crazy eights buy-ins, those kind of thing. So I'm not sure how many separate events we're going to be playing, and hopefully not as many as are on the schedule. Hopefully we'll be making a lot of day twos, a lot of day threes, and we'll be skipping a lot of these things. Look at this, we got Polarize, subbing 14 months in a row. Polarize, great to see you, man. Great to see you. And Tie-Dye Panda, I actually have been streaming quite a bit over the last few months. We're on our 47th stream. So, yeah. Pretty much every weekend. And Klein, you know what? I think I do have a I know I have a discount code for those those right Blue there. Shark optics. Just Dutch.
Dutch
is
Dutch.
The code. Z-Man making a min raise here. Go ahead and make
what
the call.
What is that funny little suit. Thing, Tie-Dye Panda? That's a funny thing. I never seen that one.
Not sure what that one is.
It's the America. It's USA. I think it's let all the be poker in the USA. LA. I don't know what it means. Do you time him or ban him?
I just ban him.
Oh, I was going to time him out.
Well,
'tis a good question, Dutch.
It's not.
It's concerning.
It's not.
I know it's not. It's a funny question.
So we got Luck Charms, buying at 600 into 800. And I'm kind of thinking that 5-3 is not going to be a call here.
A bink gong would be cool. I don't know. Charles in South Carolina SC? Is that
they use the same software?
Charleston.
Charlie in SC.
It's the same software, but it's not the same owner, I believe. Right.
It's the same software, yeah. It's a skin of 888. That's why they
so
look
and feel
different.
So is it the same owner, too, then? Or no?
No.
It's not the same owners.
The WSOP.com is owned by Caesars.
Caesars Interactive. They just buy the skin, or the rent. I guess they rent it? Is that the proper?
License?
License.
Marwin1999, good to see you in the stream, man. He says, thank God you're playing poker and not that other game. Talking about Hearthstone.
He will later, though. Dutch did a 12 run.
Yeah, we did a 12 arena. Win. 12
what?
Win arena run. That's as good as it
what?
Gets.
And it was because I was watching.
I'll tell you, Marwin, poker might be more interesting
that's
to
funny,
you.
Marwin.
And to me, for that matter. But a lot more people are watching Hearthstone.
No, I want to learn Hearthstone.
More people
it's
are watching
actually
Hearthstone.
Really complicated, man. That stuff is, there's a lot of things to know.
So we got Rock and Spin. How can he fold anything here? He'll probably raise us. Instead, he just makes the call. Now it looks like Ace Jack 2. We're going to continue our drive here. He just makes a shove. Nowhere really to go. We're here with 8 high. We're probably ahead. Turns over a 5-3 or a 5-4.
So NCC Spartan read your book, Dutch. He wanted to give you a shout out.
NCC Spartan, man. Thank you very much for giving it a read. He's talking about that book, Poker Tilt, you guys. I got a copy right here I can show off.
But I want he liked you before, but he likes you even better now.
Thanks, bro.
And he has more respect. Keep it up.
I'm really tempted here to make a call because I think Rock and Spin is making 3 bets just so light. So light.
Are your alerts on?
Yeah.
Because Pocket Protractor just subbed for 5 months. I didn't hear the little Thingy bop. Yeah, there's no... We're going to take over the poker
Okay, look
world.
At him. Just all in. It's beautiful. This is beautiful. This is exactly what we were hoping for. Gave a little... look at that chat. Take your time, dumb fuck, he says. Take your time, dumb fuck, right there in the right there in the chat. He's the guy with the 7-2s. And the 9-6s.
Oh, wait, sixes. This is the guy that does 7-2, really?
Oh, yeah.
Who's he talking to?
So he gets it all in with ace-6.
Oh, my gosh.
And gets there.
Oh, God.
And
ace,
gets there.
Or king.
Yep.
Jesus.
Not saying they're a rock and spin.
Oh, that sucks. Wow.
So, putting in another 60 here.
Oh, cool.
He goes, no, go home. Fucking bad winners are the worst, man. Bad winners are the worst.
You should silence him. He's probably having a bad day. You saw that. Did you see the Family Guy where it tells you the lessons of why people are bullies, Dutch? Because he's probably bullied.
Okay.
And that's why he's bullying you, because somebody else bullied him. And Ty, or thank you, Big O. Thank you, Big O.
Ty, Big O, good to see you, man. You think Rock and Spin makes a shove here again?
Yes, I do. I think oh, I was wrong.
What's he folding? What's he folding? He's raising with 7-2. What's he folding?
No, he's just... You know, he's probably playing spots, Dutch. He has his own rhythm, man.
Are you paying attention to what's going on, Michelle?
Yeah, I saw that he shoved there a little bit.
Do you understand the complete jackassery that we're seeing at this table? I don't think you do.
I did see the 2-7.
Okay, let's make the call here with the queen-jack suited. Completely whiff it, and we're making the fold here.
Feistrick says, Paul DeWalt says on his stream that he thinks that you would beat him live, but he thinks he has an edge on you online.
Well, we'll say that is generous of him.
I don't think their alerts are up, though, because...
they're coming up.
Are they?
Yeah.
Well, somebody asked.
They are indeed coming up.
Okay, just making sure.
So, WFKS, I got the email. Didn't actually... He says he was a lucky bone fish. I didn't actually get the hand history from you, though. So, about the worst flop we could have imagined with pocket kings here. I don't really see any point in firing out a bet here. We got Rock and Spin firing out 1260, and you know what? I'm not going to give him credit for an ace. I'm going to go ahead and make the call. I'm going to check to him, and I'm going to keep on calling, because I don't think he's got an ace. I think he's looking at, like, some sort of weird... The 7 definitely completes a lot of those weird hands that he could have. I mean, he's firing out another pot-sized bet. And you know what? I think we're ahead. So let's make the call. Let him fire out again on the river. We'll call there too. The ace helps us because now we're ahead of the 8-7s and the 7-5s. It also makes it less likely for him to have an ace. Yeah, so he's got pocket threes. And we take it down. A big double up against...
You should tell him to go home. Is that the rocket guy?
I should say, no, go home.
Now you go home, yeah.
Now go home. I'm not going to say anything to this dude. I'm not going to say
anything. Get on your rocket and go home now.
I'm just going to let my chips do the talking. Just going to let my chips do the talking. We'll just take his money. Very silently take his money. I don't need to add insult to injury.
Hold on. Somebody was asking a question about the book here. Can you? I can resend it. And does the book get sent to Norway from Amazon? Do you know, Dutch? Or like, if you were to buy a hard copy,
I think so. I think that you can get it sent to.
I have no idea. I'm going to say I think.
I think you can get it sent to Norway from Amazon. I'm pretty sure they ship internationally. Pretty sure.
Yeah, I think they do, right? But we're not from Norway. It's probably really expensive, though.
I have to say, I feel pretty good about that hand. I feel really happy about it. I feel really happy taking those chips from Rock and Spin. It feels like justice.
Let me see. I'm going to...
Donk and your mom says he's been talking mad shit for the last 24 hours.
Is he? He doesn't stop.
He's been playing a lot of cash games and just talking mad shit.
That's how he plays, man.
Sounds like a downward spiral. It sounds like that. That's what's going on. It sounds like it's just like a self-destructive behavior.
Telling you, man. His papa might have said something bad to him.
Yeah, maybe.
Now he's having a bad day. Sending you the book here to Mr. Gamblers. Let's see. Les sigh.
I'm still wondering what Rock and Spin is folding preflop. I mean, he's been so active at this table playing pretty much everything he's dealt, and then every once in a while he folds, and you just kind of have to scratch your head. I mean, if he's raising with hands like 7-2, what is he folding? Like, what could he possibly be folding here? So far, he's shown, six hands. And it's hard to, like, imagine... With the hands that he's showing, like, what does he decide is just not good enough to... to see a flop. It doesn't get much worse than a lot of the hands he's taken to the flop, so I it's a head scratcher, you guys. So we got Freezer under the gun. Strong player, but man, I really want to see flops with Rock and Spin. I'm going to make the fold here against Freezer, though. I just think that his under-the-gun 3x range here has to be pretty tight and has to put ace-10 off suit in a bad situation where we're looking at some pretty rough reverse implied odds there. Yeah, Box Brown is saying jam here if you're confident. I'm pretty sure that was...
this is the... This is
when
the...
that 7 hit on the turn...
Yeah, I'm watching it now. Wow, you were pretty in there.
The reason I'm not jamming there, Box Brownies, is because I think that there's a pretty decent chance he's drawing Stone Cold dead. You know, if he's got hands like Queen 10 and Jack 10, he's pocket threes like what he actually had. He's drawn dead or close to it. You know, dead or dead to two outs or four outs, and. I want him to go ahead and fire in that last river bluff, which he ended up doing with pocket threes in just a hopeless situation.
This is nice. So, trap. Well, he said nice trap mate.
So. A lot of times when you're in a situation like that where you're either completely dominating or completely dominated, you don't really need to be pushing your opponent off of anything. You want to go ahead and continue just letting him hang himself.
Box Brown is calling that person a bad name. I'm not going to say it on stream because, you know, it's kind of mean. But if you guys are watching a replay of the stream, you can see the chat.
So Klein Lee says, good read, Dutch. Can you tell me why you thought you were good with Kings against Rock and Spin? Well, because Rock and Spin has been playing so wide open. And because he didn't raise pre-flop. I feel like, you know, we saw him put his whole stack in the middle with ace-six offsuit just a few hands ago when we had the ace-king, and he ended up sucking out on us after all the money went in, and he, you know, got it in bad at a 3.5-to-1 disadvantage. Doesn't matter. He hits the six, no problem. Okay, ace-six offsuit. It got there. No worries. So I feel like if he had an ace, he would have been raising pre-flop. I don't think that he would have just called there. That's really the main reason why I didn't think that he had an ace. I was much more worried about hands like 8-7, 7-5, and weird combo draws like 8-6 and 9-8s and 9-7s than I was about a raggedy ace. He's playing a lot of ace rags, but he's also seems to be raising with a lot of those. And I'll tell you what else, especially on the river. When that second ace comes out, now it makes it just so much less likely. And yeah, it's in his range for sure, Klein. It's definitely one of those spots where maybe he's got an ace. You know, maybe he's got an ace, and our pocket kings are no good here. But we beat everything else. You know, especially when the final ace hits, and now we don't have to worry about those weird two pair hands like 8-7, you know, 7-5, 8-5. It's so weird to ever put somebody on 8-5. Scorpio 1107 says, Dutch, do you have to pre-register your tournament on the 31st? No, I'm pretty sure you're just going to be able to show up. Pretty sure. So a little king-queen suited here. We got Z-Man firing out a min-raise. Yeah, I'll see a flop against you, Z-Man. I don't really want to put too much action in here pre-flop. So we completely whiff the flop. Z-Man checks. Luck charms. Fires that half pot. I'll go ahead and make the fold here. Kind of putting luck charms on a hand like pocket fives. He could have a nine. He could have overcards with clubs. He could have a hand like jack ten. So Nikon Jane, good to see you in the stream. It's great to see you, Jane. And yeah, so I am on the same team with Paul Daywald. We also have Will Givens and Dave Jackson on our team.
Freezer. Is there a guy named Freezer playing? That's Paul DeWall's nemesis. Freezer. Let's see.
I don't think so. I'm pretty sure they're friends in real life.
Oh, are they?
I think. I'm not sure about that, but I think so.
Bum, 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 bum. Are we at zero or aces never cracked a meter? Oh my gosh. Heart attack. You gotta get some aces, Dutchy.
Yeah, you know what? We actually had him on the other table. I didn't switch over because it wasn't that big of a hand.
So it's one?
So is it
one? Did we win? Oh, okay.
So let me go ahead and update it. It was just a pre-flop raise, and everyone folded to us.
Oh. So.
Ferrari Doctor asking Dutch, have you watched any of Doug Polk's streams? I haven't watched any of his streams when he was on. I did watch some of his streams when his partner was on in that Upswing Poker site that he's got. And it was... he was playing cash, 2-5 cash. Looked like he was playing good. And I've seen a lot of Doug Polk on in like some talk shows. I caught him on the Tuckman show here on Twitch. It's pretty entertaining. Doug Polk was talking about losing a heads up match with James Woods in the shootout tournament last year. Hulk Me Up Too says he's going to be moving to Vegas in January. So, Hulk Me Up Too. I hope that Vegas welcomes you with open arms, man. Vegas is definitely a cool place to be if you're into poker. I definitely feel like Vegas is the center of the poker universe, especially during the summer. There's other places in the nation that are great to play poker as well. L.A., Southern Florida. Northern California, Atlantic City. There's a lot of states have thriving poker economies. Minnesota, St. Louis, but nothing's like Vegas, man. Nothing is like Vegas. As far as coaching Hulk Me Up, I've done it in the past. I don't really do too much right now, but I've got some more info on my website if you're interested. DutchBoyd.com. So we got Broy. Maybe it's B-Roy. Roy or B-Roy, 12587, he says, Dutch.
Oh, whoa, that's a long one.
I hadn't played poker in years due to a bad temperament, bipolar, next to no finances, ongoing, and a lack of time. Started watching your stream, made me love the game again. You know what? That's actually pretty high praise right there. Watching your stream made me love the game again. That's actually really high praise. Thank you very much, man. I really appreciate the kind words. He says, started playing on America's Card Room, just doing free rolls to get back into the game. Not a bad way to do it. Monday night, I took down a 677-person tourney, top prize of $2.50. Sucked, but the win felt great. I didn't attack the drowning stack. When the board scared me, I assumed it scared them too. Thanks, Dutch. B-Roy. I'm glad to hear that your interest in poker is back. I hope that it turns into a positive thing. And thanks for the high praise, man. WFKS says, at Dutch Boy, during the plus 18, aces never cracked. Were you winning lots of the tournaments? To tell you the truth, WFKS, I don't really think it has really affected our tournament win average that much. The game plan in any of these tournaments is not to get big hands. It's always more to get value out of those mediocre hands and escape when you're behind in those mediocre situations, to steal blinds, to steal flops with c-bets when you're the pre-flop aggressor in a heads-up situation, and to take flops multi-way when you're getting a really good price, and long implied odds that you take advantage of with good value bets, especially those good river value bets. It's not about having aces hold up. Most of the time in no limit hold'em tournaments, I really feel like those big hands just get in the way. A lot of times they just get in the way. A lot of times you're going to be looking down at pocket queens or pocket jacks, pocket aces, and you'll run into some stupid cooler situation where you just can't escape from from the absolute strength of the hand pre-flop. You know, poker is all about relative strength, and when you've got pocket aces, it's so hard to look at pocket aces and look at the relative strength that hand has. Once that flop comes out, it's just a pair, but it doesn't feel like a pair. It's pocket aces. It's really hard to let go of over pairs in tournaments, and yet a lot of times when you get them cracked, you look back and you realize, wow, I mean, it's not really that different from top pair, top kicker, and I just let myself get broke. Even when you get the money in good, you end up playing these inflated pots where you're putting so much of your tournament equity on the line with a hand that just, you know, frankly isn't that big of a favorite. Even with the overpairs, 85%, that's as good as it's going to get pre-flop. But you're bound to be able to get into situations, you know, in no limit hold'em tournaments where you can get a lot of tournament equity in the middle where you're 100%. That's just what ends up happening once the hand is more defined post flop, especially on the turn in the river. So yeah, I don't really feel like it had much. What are we looking at here? I don't really feel like it. It changed our in the money percentage that much when we were in those aces not cracked runs. Definitely didn't hurt though, man. It definitely didn't hurt. So Klein Lee says, still no sub sound. Yeah, I'm not sure why, man. I'm not sure why. Hack a Hand just resubbed for 5 months in a row. And we're not hearing it. I don't know why we're not hearing it.
We're gonna tickle the popcorn.
But we're seeing it. The alert boxes are at least...
Are we seeing the thing then?
We are seeing them.
Oh, we're just not
hearing
it? No.
Just not hearing them. Tepetada asking, hey Dutch, do you have any advice on what flights to play for the Colossus? Good question. Tepetada.
Oh, just one. Tepetada.
You think it's Tepetada?
Tepetida. Tepetuda. It's Tepetata. Tepetata, Dutch. Duh.
I have a stand-up joke.
No.
It's a one-liner. My safe word was potato. But she says potato. Big mistake. Big mistake. Tepetada. I would say focus on Saturday. Focus on the Saturday flights, which I think are.
You think Saturday's better?
E&F,
if you're
going
to have to play one flight, that's the one you'd play.
If I was going to just play one flight of the Colossus, I would play the 2F flight. This is going to be the flight where all the good players have had five opportunities to get through that first flight. And everybody on that last flight is going to be a little bit less inclined to be gambly, so you can take advantage of their reluctance to go home. But the most important reason is because it's on a Saturday. A lot of people are going to be coming in from L.A. and surrounding areas, Arizona, you know, flying in for the weekend to take a shot at the Colossus, and that's going to be the event that they play. The day, you know, the events on, I think it's Thursday, right? Thursday and Friday are, let me look at my calendar here just to make sure. Yeah, so it starts on Thursday, and then on Friday, there's two flights on Thursday, there's two flights on Friday, and then two flights on Saturday. You know, the two biggest reasons why Saturday would be the later flight, the two biggest reasons why that would be the one to play are, one, because it's going to have more tourist-type traffic coming in for that specific flight, and two, because... The field has already been thinned out. There's going to be a lot of good players who are playing planning on all six flights, and the players who end up not making it through on five of those flights tend to be the weaker ones, and the stronger competition will have already made it through on 2A or 2B or 2C or 2D or 2E. So by the time 2F rolls around, hopefully the field should be, on average, a little bit lower quality than what's going to be happening on Thursday and Friday. So good question, and that's my answer. I'm sticking to it. Okay, yeah, we're getting 9-1 here. We'll make the call with any two cards. I miss our old table, you guys. I miss Rock and Spin. Did he decide not to to rebuy? Is he completely out of this tournament now? Yeah, he finished in 70th. He was like, you know what? I'm done with this. If 8-5 suited doesn't hold up, then screw it. I'm done. If I can't get 8-5 suited to crack pocket queens, I'm not putting in another dime in this tournament. That's what happened. He went home. He actually took his own advice and he went home.
What happened? That our your guy is gone?
Yep. Our Mark.
Aww.
Our Mark is gone.
On this cushion that you got me. Maybe that'll work. Maybe that'll... Do you sit on your cushion? Do I look too tall for the camera?
Let me see. No, actually.
It's you look, perfect now.
You look good. You look good.
All right, back.
I've got kind of a big hand brewing in the 2K.
Oh.
Kind of want to show it off. You guys want to see? Pocket Kings. It's Pocket Kings in a situation where EP Lefty and EC Carol Ann both called as preflop. And hopefully we're going to be able to get all three bullets here against EP Lefty. Not the best river card for us, but not the worst either. We'll see if EP Lefty 15 will call with like a queen 10 or a jack 10. Decides to make the fold. We end up picking up a pretty big pot there.
Nice.
Let's switch back over to the 3K. Client asking, is Butter still on WSB? I haven't seen him stream or on the site. I've seen him on the site. He still plays on the site, but I haven't seen him stream since last year. We miss you, Butters, wherever you are. Play Poker Now asking, anyone know why you stopped streaming? I watched stream a lot but didn't hear the reason why. Probably something Yumius did, honestly. probably something Yumius said.
Where is Yumius anyways?
No, I don't know why he stopped streaming. I assume it had something to do with him winning a six-figure sum with the WSOP and deciding to just to fade off into the sunset.
He doesn't want to tell anybody his secrets.
He's retired. I think he, honestly, you know, you guys, I think that he missed out on a pretty big opportunity. I feel like
after
the World Series of Poker, a lot more people would have been interested in watching him and watching him play. I think that his popularity would have really skyrocketed if he would have stuck around on Twitch. Instead, he didn't. I know at the time, of his deep run, I was subscribed to his stream. And I was looking forward to watching more of Butter's work. Instead, I feel like he let us all down. I feel like he let the Twitch community down.
Okay.
But I can guarantee you this, guys. Okay, I will make you guys a promise. By the way, we're going to make this raise. If I happen to make a deep run in the main event, I'm still coming back in July. I will still be streaming. If I end up making the final table, by the way, we have to make this call now, and it sucks, and it's sick, and it's stupid calling with King 7 off, but we're getting 2-1 to make the call. Of course we've got to make the call. Oh. And he has, like, one of the very, very few hands that actually has us completely dominated. where we have three outs. I mean, we're hoping that he's got like an ace six or an ace five rather than a king seven. Pocket threes there would be great, and we get to have the overcards. Instead, he actually has. we're not really expecting to see ace king, so we don't want to see the bigger pocket pairs over a seven, and we don't want to see ace seven. That's pretty much all that we don't really want to see.
Tipitata. I'm gonna say it like that now.
To potato.
No, I'm gonna say tipiata. No, pipet. Oh gosh. Says thanks.
Three Bet Brett says, "What do you think about the new 90-minute blind event?" He's talking about the Solstice event. Three Bet Brett, I'm not playing it.
Yeah, we're playing the Exposed Poker tournament that day.
I actually scheduled the Exposed Poker event against that event because I really don't want to play a 90 blind level $1,500 event. The idea of playing for 4 days straight to min cash. A 1500 event sounds dreadful.
How many days until you sounds min cash horrible. For the main event does it take? It takes a few
late
days.
Late day three, usually.
Okay. Well, that's not so bad.
And it's probably going to be about the same with the Solstice event. It's probably not going to cash until day three. And it sounds, playing 3 days without cashing sounds horrible. And you're going to have to miss so many really good events.
Do they not usually take credit cards?
On a Tuesday and Wednesday and Thursday if you end up making a deep run. Do they take credit cards?
They are this year. That's what I was asking.
Poker Mindset Coach is saying that they take credit cards.
We've never used credit cards in all the years that I've been with you when you played.
Mm-hmm.
I never really considered that. Getting in debt. Dang.
That sounds kind of...
That sounds like a good way to back yourself.
Oh, huh. Man.
Oh, shit. There goes all Dutch's credit. He just built...
And you
just
get
built,
to you get to have a really good... you get to have a really good too. WSOP series.
So it begins.
A really good World Dutch, Series run every 7 years.
Keep on playing, paying it off.
Every 7 years, you give yourself a shot. Oh, man.
Well, or just pay it off. You don't have to wait every 7 years.
RT Kabuto says, fun. The last time I was at WSP, I was watching a friend play the main event, and I was standing next to Hank Azaria. I hear he has a pretty good home game in Hollywood. He would be, he'd be a lot of fun to play with. I'm a big fan of him. So we fire out pre-flop. The flop comes pretty ugly for Queen Jack. But I am going to see bet against Nimrod, and I'm going to fire out on the turn. Actually, I might check back the turn and fire out on the river. Checking back on the turn makes it look like I'm a little bit worried about a 9. Wow, so now he fires out 2496 into 3329. What is he representing here? Well, we're definitely not calling. You know, the only alternative here is to shove or fold. I just don't have the balls to shove with Queen High here. He's already put in a pretty big chunk of his stack. And the chances of somebody folding start go down the more of their stack they put in. It's also pre-rebuy period and pre-add-on period, so there's also that against a fold.
Hey, Jared. R. Good to see you, too. Have a good night.
Have a good night, Jared. And thanks Timo. For stopping by, man.
Oh, 12 months a year. Happy anniversary.
Timo. 3004, subbing 12 months in a row, man. Thank you so much, Timo. Really appreciate the resub and for sticking with us as long as you have. Really means a lot. Thank you, Timo. Thanks so much.
And Going to Go Mad is here, too. How are you doing? Long time no see. Oh, wow, look at that.
So, M. Lawson tends to play pretty tight in these spots. I'm going to go ahead and make the fold here with A6 offsuit, even though we're getting 3-1, possibly 4-1 with the guff on our left. I just think that we're going to get into a stupid situation where we could end up flopping an ace and not knowing where we're at. So I'm making the fold.
Pippin. LOL. LOL.
That would have been one of those magic flops for us, for sure.
Also, Kara G wants to know if... I don't think there is an increase in the buy-ins or anything on WSOP because of the scoops, right? It's kind of the same, isn't it? Same old same?
Yeah,
not doing same, anything.
Same,
same. Same, same. But different.
But different.
Still the same.
It's still the same.
Oh, my mom used to say that all the time. Same, same.
Did she?
Yeah. It's an Asian thing, I think. Filipino thing. Same, same. Hey, Rick the Hat. Woot, woot. Oh, yeah, there's going to be a markup for the credit cards, too, probably. The rate is probably going to be pretty high because it's a cash advance, I think they consider it, if you do it on a credit card, folks. So be cautious when using the credit card because your interest rate could be at a higher rate, which is not very good.
Good to see you again. How are you?
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Great. Dave, this is Sukin Park.
Suk?
Yes.
The Suk?
Yes.
That you won't stop talking about?
That's not true.
In Min Yorobun, Uri In Min Kungagugun, Aram Dang Kang Panel.
Yeah, I don't know what you're showing there, Dutchie.
Listen to James Franco.
Yeah, it didn't sound like the line you were looking for, though.
We're different people.
There you go.
We speak different languages. Huh? We have different faces, but inside, we are same, same. Same, same, but different. But still same.
Yeah, that's a...
thank you.
That's a thing. Yes, Dutch. Very, very funny.
Same, same. But different, but still same. Oh, man.
Oh, Iceman Kiwi, I'm sub there. I thought you didn't have the sub badge. Now you have it again. Yay! Did it not alert? Did it not do its job to alert me?
Wow.
Oh, I don't even see when it...
Okay, guys, we're on a break. We're going to get this ad on.
You should check the sound, dude. You should check the sound for the thing. And guys, if you are not subs, you're going to see commercials. But if you are subs, you're not going to see commercials.
That's one of the perks that we have.
That's the new perk.
For our subscribers. Yeah. The newest perk.
Twitch decided to bring commercials back.
Instead, you get our break time screen.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's an awesome break time
screen. You know what I think?
It's a very lovely green.
I think I want to start putting together a little 3-minute poker tips. And we'll run those on the break while we're running the commercials.
Or you can do a commercial of your book.
Yeah.
Or a commercial.
We'll figure something out.
Or we can commission someone on our stream to do a cool cartoon or something.
Yeah. If there's any animators out there. By the way, Kiwi asking, hey, Dutch, are you going to run some more home games sometime after
we'll pay
WSOP?
You.
I
Unless think you don't
so,
want to get paid.
Kiwi. I think so. I think so.
What was the question?
I don't want to promise anything and then have to go back on it.
What was the question?
Are we going to run any home games sometime after the
Oh, I hope so. I really want to. I really enjoyed them. I really did. They were pretty fun. But we have to find a home. We have to find a new software or figure out what's going on. Actually, you need to call. Did you call them, by the way? Making sure everybody was taken care of. He wanted to make sure.
I'm pretty sure everybody that signed up through Poker Zero has been paid out from the Amber.
So we might be able to use their... I mean, that's good.
Yeah, maybe. Well, I'll keep you in the loop, Iceman Kiwi.
Oh, wow. Twitcher News retweeted my tweet that I sent from your Twitter.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Very cool. Okay, guys, we're going to be back in a little 4 minutes. Don't go anywhere. Lots of great poker action left to be had. Okay, guys, we're back to it. Had a good question from Play to Cash, who asks, hey, Dutch, what are your thoughts on the bigger starting stack for main event this year? What are your thoughts on the bigger starting stack for the main event? So this year, unlike last year, they had a 30,000 chip starting stack for the main event. This year it's going to be 50,000. So five times the buy-in. What are my thoughts on that? Well, plus 16,500. I don't really think it's going to change much. I think it's a good thing. It gives kind of beginners and amateurs and the illusion of a lot more play. But the reality is, I don't think it's really going to change much. You're still going to get to a point in the tournament where you look around and the starting stack is, you know, 25, or the average stack is 25 or 30 big blinds, you know, and it's not really going to change that dynamic. All it's really going to do... Whoa! Hold on for a second.
Oh, gosh. What's going on?
We just flopped quads.
What?
Just flopped quads in the 2K.
What?
We raised
what?
Pre-flop.
And he's all in.
Basically called, and called. And now we've got this dry side pot where we've got pocket sixes. Quad sixes.
What?
So let's go ahead and fire out 2K into a dry side pot.
So yeah.
Try to inflate the pot a little bit.
It's interesting.
Crazy. So we get a call from Mike Stone. Maybe we get calls from John Blaze as well. He does. He calls. So the goal here is just to inflate that pot as best we can. So I think maybe just making the call here. And this is about as good of a run out as we could have hoped for. We've got the Stone Cold Nuts. Yeah, there we are. And we're up against threes full. What a cooler that is for John Blaze, who on a 3-6-6 board flops threes full. He's got to think that he's just flopped the world. Instead... he's up against quads, drawing dead. It's just
sick.
Ridiculously sick. Such a cooler.
Wow.
Such a cooler. The Twitch run good is real.
I hope you showed the right.
I showed it.
Okay.
So yeah, that's back cool. To what you were asking. Play to cash. Great username, by the way. I don't really expect that it's going to change much. It should raise the average skill level at the final table a little bit, but not too much. Not too much. You're still going to be at the point on day 4 or day 5 or day 6 or day 7 where you're looking around and everybody's really good. And no one is super, super deep. Everyone's just reasonably deep. It's going to happen there. I mean, it might. We're going to make the call here. That's a pretty damn good turn card for us, giving us all sorts of outs. You're still going to be in a situation where you can't really survive. Three or four bad beats. But it does give the illusion of more playtime. The reality, though, is it's not that much more playtime when you look at how many levels it's going to take to finish that tournament. By the way, we did end up getting the out we needed here.
So, Dutch, did you start those commercials because it's over now? You didn't do the commercial, did you?
No.
Okay.
No, so I wasn't worried about it.
That was just a sample of the green screen for everyone. How wonderful it is.
Yeah, if you look at how many levels it's actually going to take to complete, it's only really going to add maybe 6 hours, maybe 8 hours to the whole tournament. You know, it doesn't really take that much to get from, you know, from a 15K, 30K blind level to a 25K, 50K blind level. It doesn't take that many levels in between. So all it's really going to do is provide the losers of the tournament with an extra two or three levels. That's what it's going to end up doing. It's going to give the illusion of a lot more play, but all it's really going to do is make it a little bit slower of a process for the losing players to go broke. You're still going to get to the point on day four, day five, day six, where the difference between starting with 30,000 and starting with 50,000 just doesn't really seem to matter anymore. It's going to happen. But anything that makes the experience more enjoyable for the average player who's just playing for the experience of it, who knows, I've got a shot at winning this thing, but I definitely want to have some good stories to tell when I go home, regardless of the outcome. And that's really the lifeblood of the WSOP. You really need those players to have, to feel like they got good value. And it's kind of funny because those players feel like they got better value the more time they get at the tables. Now they feel like if they buy in for a $10,000 tournament and make it through, if they can say, well, I didn't make it to the money, but I did make it all the way to day three, then all of a sudden they feel like they got more value out of that buy-in. No one wants to say, I spent $10,000 on a tournament, or $1,500 on a tournament, or even $500 on a tournament, and I got to play for an hour and a half. They break it down, the entertainment value, they break it down on kind of a cost per hour basis, where you pay $10,000 for a tournament, you get to play 12 hours, somehow that's a better value for you than if you got to play 6 hours. So I think it's good for the game, I think it's good for the tournament, and it'll raise the skill level at the end slightly, but just slightly. I think that the reality is, it's not going to have much of a real effect, but it's going to make certain players in that tournament feel like they got better value. So it's good. Mm. Blur at 11s, no doubt about that. He says Dutch would have shut down the stream if he had pocket threes there. I would have. I would have just been like, I'm done. I'm done with poker. I quit.
Time to play Hearthstone. Forever.
John Blaze actually chills out in the stream with us, too.
Aww.
I hate giving coolers to members of the crew like that. Look at this hand here, the 2K, where everybody at the whole at the table, every single player is in except this guy, EP Lefty. Everybody saw the flop here except EP Lefty. I wonder if he's feeling left out. Ami Oslander saying, I wish there was as much excitement for that beautiful quad six pot as there would be disappointment had we been the ones with a set of threes. Isn't that just the way poker is, though? It's definitely one of those things where it feels worse to lose than it feels good to win. It's one of those weird psychological biases, loss aversion. It's been pretty well researched and proven over and over that people feel worse about losing than they do feel good about winning. That's one of the fundamental problems with poker, really. It feels worse to lose than it feels good to win. There was that great scene in Moneyball where Brad Pitt said that. He was like, I hate losing. I hate losing more than anything. I hate losing more than I love winning. And I can definitely relate to that. I think most poker players can relate to that. Feels pretty good to win, though.
You're doing
Feels
really well good in this to win. Tournament there.
Yeah, I'm doing pretty good. 9 out of 65. John Blaze back to 18,000. DeBarrel's saying nice comeback on the other table.
Chip leader in that
it
one,
is
actually.
A nice comeback.
It's a lot of people.
Very nice comeback, John Blaze. It's very easy to look down at, you know, a 3K stack in this 2K, looking at like six big blinds, and just throw in the towel. So nice job coming back. I mean, you've really given yourself a decent shot at taking this down again. Yeah, going from 3,000, six bigs, back to 17,000. You have about the same stack now as when that pocket sixes hand happened.
Hi, Tired Today.
Good to see you, Tired Today. Wow, Timo flopped quad sevens in the bike 30K.
Ooh,
nice job, man. Ended up getting 12th out of 264 for what must have been a cash. So nice job. And we get the unbeatable hand.
Oh no, which one is it?
The uncrackable hand in the 3K.
In the 3K.
Yep.
Great.
It's awesome. Feels good, man. Feels good. Firing out 700 pre-flop. Let's try to increase our...
our record there.
Our record, yeah.
This is the second time today.
Yeah.
It's good. And if any of you guys are just joining us, don't forget to follow our stream. Doesn't cost you anything, and it helps us out. Oh wow, that's a nice little flop for your aces.
It's not.
It's not.
Why is it? No, it's not.
Oh, because it scares away the any action.
Completely chills our action here.
Oh yeah, I guess
here.
It's not.
We flopped too good.
Too good. It's hit you too hard, the deck.
It really did. Oh, he's raising.
Oh, gosh.
He's raising.
Maybe
oh, my gosh.
Wait, no, he can't have an ace.
Oh, my gosh.
Or can he? Wait, can he have an ace?
He can have
yeah,
an
he
ace,
can.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, he can.
So we call here and we let him continue to fire out. Hope that he doesn't have an 8-9.
Ugh, yeah.
He's firing out again. He's firing out again. Oh man. Okay, so I guess we call here again.
But what are you hoping that he doesn't have an 8-9? Yeah, 8-9. Ugh. 8-9. Damn.
Then we're gonna go ahead and fire out on the end. Hope he has something to call us with. Yeah, it's 8-9. Fucking 8-9. So aces just got cracked for a 30,000 pot. Brutal. Brutal. This is where our hair went, you guys. Hands like that.
So back to zero. Jeez,
yeah,
Louise.
Back to zero.
Pukes.
It's like we said, big hands just seem to get in the way sometimes. Ugh, fucking brutal. So now we're on the very last spot in this tournament, 74 out of 74. That hurts.
Sigh.
Well, we shake it off. Deep breath, shake it off, try to forget about it. Look down at 11 big blinds and try to play like that never happened. So, we got a pretty big stack in this 2K, and we also have pocket queens. Fire out 1300.
So Dutch, what do you do for a living? Wootsy Wooz wants to know from your mouth, what do you do for a living? Because none of us know.
I just play poker for a living, Woots.
You
That's
take
all I do.
Take beats.
And all I do. I take beats at the poker table. take punishment at the poker table. That's pretty That's much what I do. Poker is pain management. All poker is just managing the pain of having those kind of just crushing beats. Wow, what a horrible flop for pocket queens. A 4-5-6 of diamonds. Horrible flop. And the problem with firing out a continuation bet here against these guys is overcards with a diamond in their hand just check raises. So we're going to check back here. We're assuming our hand is good on the flop, but we're going to try to dodge a diamond and then get some chips in post turn. Now though, the three of diamonds hits on the turn and our hand is just shit. So we can say goodbye to the overpair.
Ugh, that was off. This is off. Oh, here's the up time. Ugh. The wonderful thing about Twitch is reliving everything again.
Yeah, watching those aces right now.
Yeah,
how
I know.
I'm gonna listen to how I actually handle it.
Ace, yes. Oh yeah, he can.
It's loud. We call here and we let him continue to fire out. Hope that he doesn't have an 8-9.
That's a horrible 10. Yeah.
He's firing out again. He's firing that again. Oh man. Okay, so I guess we call here again.
Why do you want to relive it?
I want to hear how I handle it.
Were you hoping that he doesn't have an 8-9?
How do I take the aces cracked?
I'm gonna go ahead and fire out on the end. Hope he has something to call us with.
Oh, it's a pain.
Yeah, it's 8-9. Fucking 8-9. So Ace has just got cracked for a 30,000 pot.
Brutal.
This is where our hair went, you guys. Hands like that.
So back to zero.
I handled it okay.
You did good. Go upgrade. Can you update the?
Yeah, I can update the aces cracked meter.
Yes, those are the hands the tilt is made of. Those tilt emotes are really funny.
Sigh.
And Mike,
let's switch back over to the
Mike 3K. BSDRC says, and that is why I can't play poker for a living.
It sucks. Getting aces cracked sucks. That's what I do for a living. I just get aces cracked.
Mr. Gambler asks, have you ever come back from less than one big blind for a win? I think you have.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes.
I have. I actually did it on stream. I have it on my YouTube channel with the title, The Sickest Poker Comeback Possible.
Uplifting. Yes.
Chi-Town, I feel like it's about as uplifting as it could get. That's about as uplifting as it could have gotten there.
Well, yeah.
I feel okay.
Yeah, Queens on the other hand anyway, so we move on. Okay,
but the Queens got cracked too, Michelle.
Oh, did they?
Yes.
I didn't even see that
one. The Queens got cracked too.
I was watching this. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Gosh. I shouldn't watch your stream anymore. Man, I quit. But you had the quads, though. That was fun.
Blurred 11 says, aces cracked feels worse and quad hands feels good.
Do they have a flush
feels
here?
Feels worse than quad hands feels good.
Ugh, they did. Okay, that sucks. Sorry about them, Queens. I'm watching it right now.
So we're making the fold here with Jack 4 suited. And looking for some situation to push all in pre-flop in the next, like, 6-7 hands. I don't really feel like we can fade another big blind and small blind and retain pre-flop fold equity, so we're going to be shoving, and if we don't get a hand, 2, 3, 4, in the next 5 hands, we're shoving blind. Okay. So less than 6 bigs. We've got Dogabedes raising the minimum from under the gun plus 2. We're never getting through them, and we're never ahead. We do have an opportunity though to have kind of 1.5 to 1. I think we're going to be able to find a better spot to shove and maybe retain some pre-flop fold equity. I think so.
Okay, I'm breathing in and out.
So to be fair, there were a lot of clubs too that he could have had. It wasn't the only way we could have lost with those aces. You know, there's a lot of club combinations in the deck. By the time that river came, we're looking at like 60th nuts, 60th nuts with our top set. So you know, it's not like I can't believe we lost. It does suck though. So this is going to be the shove hand. Now it doesn't even matter if one of these guys opens. because there's a chance that we actually have an opener dominated, so we're making the shove here. But if both of them fold, we love it. Yeah, making the shove.
Let's go watch TV with Dad.
Good night, Klein.
So we get the double up and then some up against 10-9 suited, so we are pretty well ahead of that hand pre-flop. And above 10 big blinds again. Suited. I'm going to go ahead and make the fold here. We'll find a better spot, guys. I'm confident of that.
Hey, Bony Fish.
Bony Fish, good to see you, my friend.
Oh, wow. JD Cole won a WSOP seed in his league.
Oh, great. Looks like horse is getting played on the 7th. It's gonna
nice.
It's gonna be great to have you back here in Vegas, in the bracelet hunt, JD. God, what a dog shit hand this is. Under the gun plus one with king jack off suit, and 13 big blinds. It's a fold. It's too small of a stack to make a normal raise. It's that awkward spot where making a shove feels like it's putting too much at risk with subpar hand.
Hey, Krona.
Freedom 88 asking Dutch, do you base your decisions more off math or instincts? Definitely more off the math, you know, the math of things. I think I'm never in a situation where I'm looking down at a hand like 9-8 suited and feeling like, I have something in my gut says it's going to connect on the flop. You know, I'm not one of those players. And I also am not one of those players who make a call because I just have a feeling that he's weak, or I make a fold because I just have a feeling that he's strong. I'm usually going to have something to base those decisions on. I'm definitely more of a kind of player who tries to dissect tells, for example, and actually be able to explain to you why I think someone's weak or someone's strong. So I would say, definitely more the maths.
Do you need to go potty?
And M. Lawson limping here. I think we got some fold equity. Pick up 25% of our stack. Back up a jack 8 off. KG poker, open limping, and yeah, it's a fold. Eleven bigs, we got the open limper. Make the fold here. Doing better. Still at about 11 big blinds, 56.72. We got EDM727 in the stream. Good to see EDM.
What's up? Hey,
I think it's Ed M.
Hey,
sorry,
Baluti, man. Or Balutelli, Balutelli, maybe Balutelli. But on the real, I'm headed to WSOP New Orleans this weekend with your buddy Jason from Louisiana Saturday. Cool.
Jason Bullock.
Have I met Jason?
I don't think you have, Michelle. I'll make the fold here for 11 bigs.
Oh, thank you, JD. You're awesome. Did you ban somebody when I was gone? Was there some banning? Oh.
Yeah.
Well, we saw that coming. people are just haters. Babe, you must have been a saint because you have three bracelets. Do you want this treat? June's bored of retreats. What do you need, baby? Do you want a hug? Do you want to come on the stream? No? Here. Get it. June doesn't like her toys anymore.
So, making a raise in this 2K. You guys want to see it? Old Jack 10 suited hand. Harvey jumper making the shove. And I just feel like Jack 10 suited is going to hit. So, I'm going to make the call because I got a gut feeling. No, not really. We're getting more than 2 to 1. Make the call with the Jack 10 suited. Hope not to be completely dominated. And, yeah, and then we end up going up against one of the hands that do actually dominate us. Kind of hoping that he has like an ace-king, ace-queen, smaller pocket pair type hand there instead of king-10 or ace-10 or queen-10 or ace-jack. King-jack or queen-jack. So, 11 bigs, ace-10 offsuit. We're kind of faced with this decision more often than I like. It's going to be a shove. It's going to be a shove. I don't love it, but it's too good of a hand to fold, and our stack is such that making a normal raise doesn't really do much for us. So we make the shove. If we get called, we're hoping to get called with smaller pocket pairs. Sometimes we get called, you know, from a small blind or big blind stack with a weaker ace. Ace-9, ace-8 sometimes calls us. Corona. Corona says, I once beat Johnny freaking Chan in a pub once.
Johnny fucking Chan.
I'm just gonna try to outplay him. Just this one hand.
Do you feel like people play at you more because you're Dutch boy?
No, I don't think so. I actually think it's the opposite. I feel like I get...
Really?
I feel like I get more respect for my raises. People tend to stay out of my way. I feel like they don't defend as much. Gosh, I hate making the fold here. We're getting 6-1 on this fold, but it's also so much of our stack pre-flop. You put a move on Chan, you son of a bitch. You put a move on Chan. Okay, we're gonna make the fold here. That was the funniest scene in Rounders when he's describing how he outplayed Johnny Chan just one hand. They're playing limit hold'em.
It's limit.
And they get five bets in pre-flop. And he somehow gets Johnny Chan to fold even though he's getting like 12-1 on the flop. It makes zero sense.
They thought that Rounders Zoom was stupid. So you can beat Chan in one pot. It takes more than one pot, yo. Everybody's doing their bad, their. I guess, what do they call that? Good beats when you beat out somebody?
I guess it was four bet, right?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, you're talking about the Johnny Chan thing?
Shorthanded.
Yeah, honey, I you know, I've seen that movie exactly once and maybe a half. How many times have you? You've seen that movie a lot.
How many times have I seen Rounders?
Yeah.
Oh, I've lost count.
I think I've seen... You've probably seen Rounders as many times as I've seen Never Ending Story.
Yeah, probably.
Probably. I know all the
That's
words.
Probably right.
Well, I used to know all the words to Never Ending Story. Do you know all the words to Rounders? Like, can you recite it from the beginning? Could you have in the past?
No.
Oh, really?
I can get pretty deep into the first scene.
Oh, okay. Surprised that you think you need to watch some Rounders.
But no, I don't have the whole
ninety minute
screenplay memorized.
I think you should need to commit yourself.
Blurred 11 says, can anyone confirm Vanessa Selbst quit poker to go back to practicing law? I don't believe that for a second, Blurred 11s.
I don't either.
Loki 9, welcome to the crew.
Yay,
just clicking on that
Loki
sub button. Loki, thank you very much. Really appreciate you supporting the stream. You get some cool emoticons.
Oh,
you also get some
swag.
Do I
have any fist bump patches? Do you have a fist bump patch?
Fist bump patches. Right
can
there.
Do I have one?
Yeah. Jeez. Right on.
Give me a black eye.
Weird toss.
No, so yeah, there it is.
Okay, we're gonna make the fold here with 9-5 off.
Beautiful stitching with 1, 2, 3, 4 colors.
Let's go back to the
3K. Genuine fist bump patch can be yours.
This will be a shove, I think. Yeah, 11 bigs. We don't really have 11 bigs either. You see, it's going up to 300, 620 seconds, so we've got less than 10 big blinds in front of us.
Don't you ruin my thing.
We're not going to have a lot of situations here where we can make a shove and have some fold equity, so this is going to be a shove here. Can we shove over KG Poker here? No, we'll make the fold.
You have the wrong table up?
So, Loki 9, you get a couple fist bump patches. You're also going to get a Poker Tilt ebook. My book.
And
270
and
pages.
Can you read what some of the comments are on the back of that book from Poker Pro Lane Flack? What did he say?
He said, I haven't had time to look at it. I'm sorry. Quote something for me and I'll stand by it. From Lane Flack.
Lane
Flack. Six-time WSOP winner.
And
a WPT.
What about Jeff Madsen?
Jeff Madsen says, Dutch's personal story is fascinating, a refreshingly unique perspective through the poker boom and beyond.
I can't wait to see the poker gang, poker crews, everybody in the poker world, WSP. And Nolan Dalad, doesn't he say something pleasant? And
he does.
A wonderful writer. If you have a chance to read his blog, guys, yeah, I recommend
Nolan.
It.
He's great.
He's a wonderful, wonderful writer.
Funny, sad, riveting, thought-provoking, and always on edge. This book is an amusement park of emotions. Thank you for that, Nolan Dalad. So pretty good reviews, and yours for free when you click on that sub button. So I hope you get a chance to read it, Loki.
Yeah, and not only that, you get the emoticons.
It's going to be a shove from us. Sometimes we're ahead of KG Poker. Sometimes we get through. We actually have enough chips here that sometimes we actually get through KG here. Probably not. We're probably not getting through, but enough of the time KG Poker has like a King Jack or King 10 or Queen Jack or Queen 10. That this is a good shove, in my opinion. So he makes the call with Ace King, ends up having one of the hands that we don't want to see. Doesn't matter. We end up chopping that pot. Wow.
Wow. Lucky ducky.
So getting pretty lucky there. Getting pretty lucky there. Bonyfish says, are you in the money in the 2K guarantee? No, we aren't. It starts paying at 15. We're 17 out of 40 right now, so still have to lose a little over half the field.
And you get these lovely emotes when you join the crew. And the most important thing, Dutch, you don't get any commercials. Oh, they moved you here. Where'd you go in this lobby?
Jack Carver says, at least it's more believable than that James Bond Casino Royale hand. Yes, it is. It is that.
I remember that hand. I think we watched it a few times, didn't we?
God, that was the worst. That was one of the worst all-time poker scenes in all of film. In all of film, that was one of the worst poker scenes.
I don't think so. I'm sure we can find another
one. It was bad. You know what was actually one of the best poker scenes I've seen in a movie
Star
or
Trek.
Television show?
Star Trek.
No, not Star Trek, The Next Generation. You know what was great about Star Trek, The Next Generation? They actually end that series with Picard coming in and playing poker with his crew. I think for the first time in the 7 or 8 years that the show was on, they always had poker scenes, right? But it was always the officers playing each other, and Picard never joined in the game until the very last episode, where the last scene of Star Trek is Picard coming in and playing poker. How great is that? How fitting is that? I loved it.
That was good.
We rewatched all the Star Trek The Next Generation over the last
it took a while.
The last year.
No, it took a longer. A
couple
than
years.
That. Yeah.
So we're making the shove here with pocket tens. It's a good hand.
Good. That's good.
Figures to be ahead. Sometimes when we get called, we have to dodge his overcards. Sometimes we have to suck out against an overpair. But we're never folding there for 10 bigs.
Hey, Malcolm.
Malcolm, great to see you. Good evening to you, too.
Hey, Dutch, am I the rake?
Women are the rake, yes. Yes, Michelle is the rake.
I am the rake. That's what they should have. We should have a rake emoticon, dude.
So there was a poker scene in Lie to Me. This was the one about...
is this the worst one or the best one?
One of the best ones.
Oh, the best
one. One of the best ones.
And it's, what's the show?
Lie to Me.
Oh, I don't know if I've seen that. Lie to Me? It's a movie, or...?
Yeah, I'm trying to think of it's a television show, and it's about an expert in body language.
Is that the one with like white collar, blue collar, or?
No, it's called Lie to Me.
Okay.
It's with Tim Roth, it's Cal Lightman, and there's a poker scene. I think it's in season one, where. He makes a call on the turn with a Jack 10 on a King Queen board, and then on the river the guy fires out a big bet all in, and he calls him with just Jack high, And the way the hand played out, and the way the action went down, and the fact that he, like the way that they made it so that he was calling with a really weak hand, but it was believable, where it was like a believable bluff catcher, it was just great. You know, I looked at it and I was like, you know what, that's a really good poker hand. That's like, how often do you see that where like the big, you know, drama is that he's making a call, like a hero call, without the, like, you know, flush versus, you know, straight flush or royal flush versus quads or some stupid made up Hollywood hand. Instead, it's a hand where it's like a missed draw, but it's still good. And he just like looks him down, he stares him down, and he knows. Oh, you know what else was probably the worst poker scene in modern film? Was
I just don't remember watching
that movie In Time, I think is what it was called, right?
But In Time.
Yeah, we're going to make the shove here against J-Flo. Sometimes he's slow playing with like a hand like aces or something. It doesn't matter, though. We've got a big enough hand that we've got to just go ahead and take the chance that we're ahead. Kid Poker PL making the shove, and we're ahead of Ace King. Can we dodge the six out or dodge and weave? We do. Up to 14,000. The comeback is happening. In Time. In Time. The movie In Time.
Big Lebowski sub for 13 months in a row, Dutch. Thank you so much for the resub, dude.
Big Lebowski, awesome. Thanks so much, dude. Really appreciate you being here and keeping the stream alive. Thanks for being such a positive part of the crew. It's really awesome of you to keep that sub button
Klein
going.
Klein also sent a tweet. I don't know
keeping
if you want to
sub badge going.
If you want to show the picture of show the picture on stream about his hat, his lucky golf hat.
Yeah, let me try.
Can you show it on there?
I've been having some problems sharing a Chrome screen.
Oh, you know what? I'll retweet it from your from yours, though.
Definitely get the retweet.
Are you retweeting it?
Yeah.
Or am I?
I love it. I love it. It looks great, man. Let me see if I can show it on stream here.
I'm going to see it, too.
I've been having issues with my XSplit screen captures here. It's just been, it's just been capturing black, and I have no idea why.
You probably need to upgrade something.
I mean, something. I didn't change anything. So that's supposed to be a hat.
Can you see it? Do you want me to show it just from my phone? Can you see it from my phone?
Yeah, give it.
Can you
it
see
a
it
shot.
Right here?
Kind of. It's not really.
I can probably put it on the internet, and you can probably see it from there, dude.
Well, I can see it. I see it on my Twitter, but I try to share it on the.
No, I can put it on Imgur. I can probably put it on Imgur, Dutch.
Okay. Well, I
just
wanted to show it on
sec.
Stream, and it's not working.
Yeah, but then you can show it on a link, and then you can show it. Oh, you can't do that, can you?
Yeah. I don't know why.
I was trying to be a genius, and it didn't work. Gosh, that's the last time I tried to do that again.
I mean, something with Chrome is just not showing up on XSplit, and it just started happening like in the last couple of streams. It's very frustrating. Checkered Karma. How did I like the end of Maverick?
Maverick always reminds me
of... It was kind of goofy, man.
I don't remember the end of Maverick.
I love the idea. I love the idea that you can just close your eyes and will the universe to bend to the way that you want it to. You know, I love the idea of just being able to will a certain card out of the deck into the flop. But,
did you retweet this already?
What was it? I'm trying to remember. I think the end of Maverick was a stud hand, right? It's like a five-card stud hand or something.
Cool. I don't know how you guys remember all these hands, man. Yeah, I don't remember Lie to Me. Did we watch it together? I kind of feel like we did.
We were watching it with my mom.
Yeah.
We watched a few episodes with my mom.
Yeah, I can't believe you remembered that.
Nikki two cards says, talking about that lucky you scene where he folds folds to his dad. He rips off his back or and dumps his chips to his dad. I mean, that was the worst. And then the dad, yeah, no spoilers.
Do you remember the do you remember the last hand in the Grand?
We can spoil it.
The Grand was a really good movie. I don't remember what happened. Do you remember The Grand with David Cross?
Yeah.
Do you remember that
Ray hand? Romano? I don't remember The Last Hand. I don't remember how it played out.
I don't know. We're never going to be able to find that. We have to watch it again. That was a good movie, though. That's my favorite poker movie.
So we got a little King 2 offsuit action with 17 bigs making the fold.
So what's your goal, Dutch, for the followers?
Follower goal?
Yeah. 12,400. We're going to hit that 400.
You know what I would like to see? I would like to get up to 13,000 followers before the World Series. I feel like that's doable. I feel like we could do it. We could definitely do it with your help. Guys, if you haven't followed the stream yet, click on that little follow button. It's right underneath the video. We just got Play Poker for Health following the stream. It'd be awesome if you'd follow the stream, too, if you're not following the stream already. It doesn't cost you anything.
Oh, my gosh. Randy Savage is on your table. Uh-huh. That's funny.
I remember that Ghost of M, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, just, like, being lucky. That was just goofy. But my favorite was that In Time, man. That In Time movie where Justin Timberlake, he like gets all of the money in the middle for his life. You know, it's like they're betting life units, and he gets all the money in the middle on the turn with a gut shot straight draw.
Oh, when it's they're not, betting their life.
Yeah, and it's not money. It's like life units. It's like, and they're playing like table stakes or something. If he doesn't win the hand, he's gonna drop dead at the table. But he does win the hand. I'm gonna go ahead and make the check here. I feel like
for his life.
I feel like we'll just take a free flop. We're actually gonna give Dogabetes that bony fish as well. So the open-ended straight draw with overcards. Dogabetes firing out a half pot, saying what? Saying he's got. He's got nothing here, man. Maybe he's got an ace. If he's got the ace, we still have 11 outs. And you know, I just don't think he's got the ace. So let's go ahead and make the raise here to 4,800. And yeah, we're prepared to get it all in here, Dogabetes. I don't like it. I don't like it, but we've got at least 11 outs. Let's make the call. Okay, so we've got 8 outs. It's not one of them. It's not one of them, guys. That's going to do it for our 3K. We tried to stage the comeback.
Kinda, yeah, you know what? You kind of did come back.
Kind of.
Kind of, and then.
Kind of.
Kind of.
C-Mac 85. I remember Tilt, too. I remember that line. They're like, double it, then triple it. We got to double it, and then triple it. Okay, guys, we're on break. I'll be back in about 3 minutes. Don't go anywhere. We still have this shot. 15 out of 33. Have to lose about half the field to get to the money at this point. $1,000 up top. I'll take it. We'll be right back.
Yeah. That's the Abilify talking, dude.
For a billion? No, I would do that.
No, you would not.
No one lives forever. You could do a lot of you could do a lot of cool stuff with a billion.
No, you wouldn't. No, you would not do it for a billion, Dutch.
Yes, I would.
No, you wouldn't.
Yes, I would.
No, you wouldn't, Dutch. If you did, then, no, you wouldn't.
Okay, at some point, it just becomes unethical not to. Yes, it does. Not to give that a shot.
No, you're not going to do it, Dutch.
You know, you can cure world hunger for a year for $30 billion.
Just don't argue with me. You're arguing with me for no reason. I said, no, you're not. You're not doing it.
I don't take my orders from XMOA.
Yes, you do when it comes to things like that.
Okay, we'll fire out 2,500. Fire out the same amount. Getting a quick check from Diane. We're going to fire out all three bullets here? I don't think so. I think we're just going to give up right here, right now. And if Diane turns over some lame hand like Ace 10, well, more power to her. Jack 7, nice hand. Out of the gun plus one, Ace 9 offsuit. Sure. ZASD of Unreal said, I'd do it. I've been running real good lately. Got three legendaries in my last four Hearthstone packs.
Oh my gosh, you guys are
some really awful. Good run good, man. Okay, let's fire out. Same amount in the paint, in the big blind. And Ace 9 offsuit should be the best hand here. We'll try it. If in the paint decides to make a little check raise action, I'm not going anywhere. I'm going with a hand. Thinking that Ace 9 offsuit is the best of it. There's really not that much of a difference between Ace 9 offsuit on that flop and a hand like pocket threes or pocket fours. And if you're going to let go of the ace high, then I guess, I mean, sure, there's some hands that beat you there. Plenty of pocket pairs in the deck, you know, plenty of fives for that matter, but you're ahead of pretty much everything else. JD Cole 72 asks Dutch, if I wanted to meet Billy Baxter, where would I go? Does he play the Aria? Will he play a Deuce of Seven event at the WSOP? I played a Deuce of Seven event with Billy Baxter last year at the WSOP. Ended up getting 11th in it. I did, not him. So I'd imagine that he'll be playing year at the series. Usually I see him playing at the Bellagio when he's playing cash games. And the last time I played with him in a tournament was at the Bellagio in the 15K. So I'm going to say that your best shot at meeting Billy Baxter would be going to the World Series of Poker during any of the lowball events. And my guess is he's going to be there. Let's go ahead and make the call here, getting like 4-1, even though we've got some nasty reverse implied odds here. I am going to defend, though, against Mambo's under-the-gun raise. Okay. So we flop the ace. Now what? This is the problem with having a hand like ace 10 offsuit. Well, now what is we're going to go ahead and check. And we're calling the c-bet on the flop. He fires out 3,200 and 9,600. Make the call.
Hey, legal action.
The turn comes in 8 of hearts, which should be a good hand for us. Or it should be a good turn for us. It doesn't really change anything. If we're ahead, we're still ahead. If we're behind, we're still behind. We'll check to Mambo and be prepared to make another call here. So he fires that half pot now. We could be learning a lesson in reverse implied odds. We're behind an ace jack, an ace queen, an ace king. We're ahead of a lot of hands though. And yeah, we're making the call. He's going to actually have to show us something better than Ace-10. 8 of clubs hits. So probably slow him down. It's pretty easy for him to put us on a club flush here. It does end up slowing him down. So the eight of clubs actually saves us some money there on the river. And Mambo deciding not to get value out of that top two pair.
Dutch Wrecked One has been watching us for a year, and it's the first time in chat, so you should say
hi. We'll make the fold here against Mambo. Wrecked, welcome to the stream. Good to see you. I guess welcome to the chat. If he's been watching and this is the first time he's chatting, mm-hmm. Welcome to the chat.
And Play the Poker for Health is here, too. So welcome.
We'll make the fold here against Diane's all-in shove for 10 bigs. Losing Randy Savage. And the players are dropping pretty quick at this point.
Louis Helm subscribed for a year, 12 months in a row. And Loki wants to know if we do home games. And we have done home games in the past, and I think we may be doing home games in the future. We have to figure out where we're going to, what software we're going to use for that. We can't use Stars because they don't have the max amount of people.
We had Louis Helm resub in 12 months in a row. He says, don't kill yourself, Dutch.
Yeah.
Jeez, I'll resub already.
There you go.
I would never off myself, Louis.
Only for $1 billion.
No.
Nah, I know.
No.
I know. It's a gamble. Then he's going to break down the math. But
I'm
you know what?
Irritated the way that you're, right now.
But the way that you're running, Dutch, I don't think it would be a good bet for you.
You know what?
I think you're dead.
Lately, it's been a little rough, but overall, I can't complain. So, Louie, thanks very much for the resub, man. We also have Dakota Cohoon resubbing 10 months in a row. It's awesome to have you here. Dakota, thanks so much, man. I really appreciate that. Interesting. So TN Putnam making a little 4x raise here. A little much. Yeah, you know what? We're ahead here. I'm going to go ahead and make the shove. We're going to pick up a third of our stack here. We got the best hand. If not, we're probably in a coin flip. Yeah.
Oof.
Okay, so we don't have the best hand. So we got pretty lucky on that turn.
God, that was really lucky.
Got the out on the river. So that's gonna be it for us. 29 of 145. T. Putnam.
I didn't see that. Oh, that's gross.
Firing out a 4x raise with ace queen off. In the late stages of the 2K guaranteed. I'm under the gun plus one. I just feel like, in my book, ace queen, ace king are big enough hands where usually you're not going to see somebody make it that much pre-flop because they scare away their action. Felt like we were going to be ahead. Felt like we were going to be looking at a hand like pocket fours pocket sixes if we got called, and a lot of times we just get through. Wrong read, Dutch. Wrong read.
Well, you can be happy that wasn't a gun.
Yeah, I can be happy about that.
Well, I guess if
let's not talk about it anymore. Okay, guys, we're going to be done for the night.
Do you want to play
34.
Some Hearthstone, or are you done
for
the day?
No, I'm done for the day. I'm done for the day. We'll be back tomorrow, though. We'll be back around probably around 7:30 tomorrow for some more 2K and 3K guaranteed
reboot.
Action. And you guys are awesome. Thanks for joining us. Hope things are going well with you, and I hope that I hope we make some deep runs this weekend.
Yeah, and if you
been getting close,
if you aren't
no
following,
cigar.
If you aren't following, make sure you follow. There's a little button right below me.
Yeah, make sure you follow the stream. Thank you guys for all the follows and all the sub badges. You guys are awesome. We'll be back tomorrow.
Yeah. So
see you later.